Hello everyone! Welcome to episode 47!
Yesterday, one of my friends called me and then she told me that she's having some kind of disturbance at home. So I said, what happened? Then she told me that like 3 to 4 days ago, she actually was walking by a road and then she stepped on something.
Mm.
And then when she looked, right, it was a bangle. Okay, first she actually ignored. But after that, something like attracted to her, like she was attracted because she said the bangle was very nice and unique.
Okay.
And then she brought it back to her house.
Hey, this kind of thing shouldn't bring because like it was like out of the blue suddenly something there, is it?
Yeah. She was walking right there, she stepped on it. But first she actually wanted to ignore, but after that she said that the bangle looks very nice.
Because these kind of things are like, sometimes can be like lashed onto the object, you know. Yeah, like you'll never know it belongs to like someone who passed away or what. Then
So do you have like come across these kind of stories before?
Sixth Avenue bungalow. Okay, this happened many years ago. There was this night when my brother came back quite late lah. Then after that, he was so excited to show me something. So I was like, hey, I found this, I want to show you this thing. And all that. Then I was like, what is it? He showed me that, he showed me this very like olden days kind of like pen, you know. Like it's like those days type where, when I looked at it, right, it was like, didn't have those like refill tube inside. It was like basically you need to touch the ink and write that kind of thing. And also he found like a those days lighter. You know lighter, no? So I was like, okay, so where did you find all this? Then he said, me and my friend, we just went to explore lah. Because that time my brother passed license, so my father will often let my brother drive his car lah. So my brother will pick up some friends, go out on their own and all that. So then he told me this story lah. He said that they were driving along 6th Avenue. So 6th Avenue, guys, I think most of us know that there are a lot of bungalows there. So it happened to like, they just like, so-called like window shopping lah. So just like seeing all the bungalows there, just driving by. They came across this very dark entrance, you know. So the way he described, right, he said it's like a entrance. Then there's this very dark gate there. So it's at night lah. So there's no electricity at the area, that particular compound lah.
Okay.
So it was very dark. So in the darkness, when he peeped through the gate, right, he saw quite far away, you know. That means there's another drive through all the way, and there's this bungalow there. Very dark, no? So my brother and his that friend were a bit like excited lah. So they climbed the gate and they went in. So as they went in and all that, they keep walking in and in, they realized that they were in total darkness. So when they turn behind to see, right, it's like only the roadside and that gate area only got like this small light only. They were actually in total darkness. So like my brother had his own lighter and all that, so he just like light the area lah. So as he went into that, the door wasn't locked or anything, the main door of the bungalow. So when he went in, he said like there were no furnitures, like quite dusty and all that, but not vandalized or anything. It was like just abandoned. He said that there were some cracks here, like some fallen off like areas, like the walls like got cracks, like a lot of holes and all that. Then behind there was this like swimming pool which is empty. Swimming pool empty, and then there's some more like space behind, like a backyard of the bungalow. So it was quite a big one lah. Then after that, they decided to chill at the second level of the bungalow.
Okay.
So they were, I think, I don't know what they were doing lah. Maybe like just talking, smoking, and all that kind of thing. And then he stumbled upon this like pen and a lighter. So he brought it back, he like kept it in his pocket immediately. Okay, he find like very unique. Yeah, when I saw it also, it was like quite unique, like cannot find this in the shop anywhere, no? So I just, then after that I just say that, so after that how y'all came back? Then I was like, then I say that, we come on, we climb up the gate again and all that. Then we drive back ready lah. So I was like, okay. Then in my mind also I was like thinking, next time don't take things like this lah. Not because of the supernatural part, it's like certain things just leave it back there lah. Maybe it belonged to someone, no? Okay. After that, when we went to sleep, around 3 to 4 a.m.
Okay.
There was like very strange knocking sounds in my room door. Then like, I got disturbed. So sometimes maybe I thought maybe my mom is like, I want to tell us something. Or when I open, there's no one. So this one right, I clearly remember. The time me and my brother were sharing a room lah. So when I closed back the door and I was walking, right, walking back to the bed, I heard footsteps approaching the door and knocking again. So I went back, I opened the door, I checked, nobody. So I went to my parents' room. So I opened very slowly because night already, they will be sleeping. I opened to check, they are asleep, they are fast asleep. Thinking, what lah, this thing, like, what is it, and all that. So, my previous home, right, is my parents' room, followed by a common bedroom, which eventually turned out to be my room lah, in future. And then, our bedroom then, me and my brother. So, the center room, right, last time we had this, the door magnet problem. So, the door won't, every time it hinged to it, it would like, loose lah. The windows were all closed, I clearly remember. But when I walked past from my parents' room to the my bedroom, right? I was walking past, right? The center room doors slammed shut. So then I was like, then I opened my, the center room and to check anything, there was nothing. But what was eerie was, the place where I was standing, right, was a bit cold. Only the bedrooms only had aircon and all that. Center room not on. My parents don't use aircon. Only my brother's bedroom only like aircon. But it was like surrounding area was quite cooling. So I was a bit like worried. And then it struck in my mind. Maybe because my brother took these items with him and all that, you know. So the next day, right, I remember, I after my brother's work finished already, I say, why not we just go chill somewhere lah, we just talk and all that lah. Okay, then with my brother was this another friend named Jagan. So we all just gather, we just like chit chat, talk. Then I asked him, is this thing necessary or not? Then my brother say, no lah, appa like to collect all this lighter and pen, right? So I thought I want to put in the display. I say, you know, last night got a lot of disturbance, you know. So maybe it's because of this thing, you know. Then the friend asked, hey, what happened? Tell me lah, bro, what happened? So I explained to him. My brother said that he went with his friend, another friend inside. He chilled there, then he found this thing. Then he got upset. He said, hey, you shouldn't take things back home, nah, this kind of thing. All it's abandoned, you won't know the history behind it.
No, no.
And you'll never know what is, who, maybe it's like somebody who died and that's that person's belongings, no. Then my brother like, hey, I don't know what to do now, lah, how and all that. So the friend suggested, now the things are with you, right, fine. We just go back to the entrance, you just throw back inside the gate lah, and then we just leave the place lah.
Just don't use
lah. Return back lah. We no need to climb back, go inside and all that.
Just put it there.
But my initial idea was, we climb back, put where it was. Because okay, like, not nice lah. So after that, it was about 11 p.m. or 12 p.m. Again, my brother borrowed my father's car. So we went there. Approaching that place already, right, I felt like we weren't alone like that. Seriously, I was like, as though like, surrounding the cars, there were many eyes looking like that. Very uneasy. So my brother, his friend in the front seat, my brother in the driver's seat, I was at the back. Upon arriving this bungalow, right, I changed my mind. I didn't want to go inside there. But I find it was like awkward, extremely quiet. Totally no insect sounds, no nothing. Not even a lizard sound, no.
No, so quiet.
Very quiet. My ears all were like ringing in silence, you know. No, that kind of annoying ringing, you know. Then my brother's friend Jagan, he said, hey, pass me the lighter and this one. He went there. He just prayed. He just he didn't throw inside, like, he put his hand inside, he just like dropped
it. Okay.
And then it came. But I don't know what happened, what made me do this. I had this phone, 3220 if I'm not wrong. Nokia. The lights will be there are lights around the phone. Bling bling lights, you know. At the time I was having this phone, I just wanted to just take the picture of the gate. Because the gate was very nice. It was like very unique. Like the, you know, like curls line on it. You know, like very unique structure, you know. So I was like, okay, just take the picture of the gate. The house cannot be seen. Totally dark. So I just took a picture. I didn't like totally see it. I just kept back into my pocket.
Just take photo then.
I just take it. So the... But my brother's friend, right, when he came back to the car, right, he was perspiring. He said, hey, take the car and go. Then my brother like, hey, why da? I said, hey, quiet and just drive, da. Don't stay here. So I think he saw something, no? So at the back of the car, right, I just took out my phone. I saw the photo. I told my brother to stop the vehicle. Because what I described was, the house is totally dark, only the gate can be seen because of the roadside light, right? The photo emerged as, the house was well lit. The side of the gates had these lamps, were lit. And there was this image in front of the gate. My brother saw, he got shocked. Jagan saw and he got shocked because he said that there was something approaching the gate. We all had this goosebump moment, guys. Seriously, because that photo was very grainy because those days camera, the phone not so clear, but it's so clear cut that this thing happened and we were all shocked. Then we didn't know what to do. I remember because last time this phone I doubt had Bluetooth function, so I MMS this phone to my email to keep, you know, like, so anytime anybody asks or so, I can just show lah. But sadly the time I used to have this box computer. Then we changed computer, right, in Khatib. Then sadly that photo has been erased. I don't have that photo to show you guys. But I take it as it's for the better lah, because it was a very haunting image. So after that thing happened and when we came back home, right, immediately that night, the following night or the after, right, the night after, no disturbance.
So it was so clear cut, it's because of the
objects. The pen and the lighter. So I shared this with like my cousin and my brother's friends, the other whenever we hang out lah. Then they were like, hey, next time don't go and take things all lah. See anything, okay, nice ah. You want to see, just see, then just leave it there.
Best don't
take back lah. I mean, it was antique things, but
yeah, but finding this in this kind of places,
better
not to take lah.
Correct. Yeah, but I don't know how many of you guys have coincidentally been to this bungalow, but this was one kind of experience lah, like, which actually nearly affected my house that one time. Imagine if I never thought about it or like ignored it, that it would have prolonged, or you know, worse things could have happened.
Okay, so it's a very, very creepy story and also a lesson to everyone not to take other people's belongings.
Or if you find anything on the road or anywhere, wherever y'all are, y'all find anything or what, try not to take, even if it's money also.
Yeah, unless it's like some kind of wallet, some better give it to the police.
Yeah, exactly.
This kind of like lighters or comb or anything.
Yeah, try not to take lah.
Better not to take. Okay? So, we have come to the end of our episode. We will catch up with the next one. So, until then, signing off, Varshan.
Anju.
Ciao.